Okay, you can bop me. I have to ask a couple of things about Justin.
Okay, of course.
He has gone on television and pretty much said, you broke his heart. You did something that caused him so much pain, so much suffering. What did you do?
I was upset. I was upset for a while. I think we're both really young, and it was kind of waiting to happen. And I will always love him. He'll always have a special place in my heart. He is such a great person.
But you said, I've only slept with one person in my whole life, 2 years into my relationship with Justin. And yet he's left the impression that you weren't faithful, that you betrayed the relationship.
I think everyone has a side to their story, and to make them feel a certain way, and make them feel, you know, and I'm not technically saying he's wrong, but I'm not technically saying he's right either, so.
You've had a rough year. You've had a year that would test a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
Illness in the family.
Mm-hmm.
A breakup. This spasm of publicity about what happened from Mexico to London.
It was pretty rough, yeah. Yeah, it's kind of weird. Ah, weird. Hello. Oh my goodness, hello. Ew, strong Britney. Yeah, it was a weird. I'm embarrassed. Can we stop?
Do you like your voice?
Do I like my voice? I'll be completely honest. I think my voice is okay. I like the feeling that I get when I sing. It's not so much my voice. It's a state that I go in when I sing that I really like. In the Zone is probably the one song that really states where I'm at. I wanna get in the zone.
And to make it to the next stage, she's made her zone racier than ever. For instance, on the new album, a song called Breathe On Me, which she tried to tell me is just about breathing.
You really feeling. Think that's what it's talking about?
It says, I mean, that's what it says. It says breathe on me. That's it.
Says. I know what it says, but one of us wasn't born yesterday. Do you really think that's all it's talking about?
Well, I think it's supposed to get you in the mood. You know, like certain songs get you in the mood to feel a certain tension or a certain vibe.
And the girl who always played it close to the line on how much skin she showed posed like this for Esquire magazine. Consider the line officially crossed. She volunteers to me that I don't even know about another song on the new album. A song about, well, I think I'll let her tell you.
I have one song that's called Touch of My Hand. That's talking about you with yourself, which is a little much. But it's a reality that we have. And yeah, okay. I think we all have sides to us. I think that, yes, I can relate to that song, and like we all can. You'd be lying if you said you couldn't, but there is it's not something you openly talk about with a lot of people. It's something sacred, and it's something I wanted to write about, so.
Sacred?
No, the song, Touch of My Hand, talking about indulging in yourself.
And that's sacred?
It is sacred to me, but in a way, exploiting it. Okay, I'm confusing myself right now.
I'm just gonna lean back here and just...
What's the question again? Go ahead.
I don't remember the question.
I don't either. Okay. Okay.
Wait a minute. Can you rewind that tape? Am I seeing what I think?
That's probably one of the moments that I remember that I like the best.
You can pop your knuckles.
Britney Spears is popping her knuckles.
How do you do that?
I don't know.
What happened to your clothes?
I have on clothes now.
I know. But what's this about? No kidding. What is it about?
What is it about?
Yeah.
It's about doing a beautiful picture.
Is it about shocking people?
About shocking? You know what? I feel comfortable in my skin. I think it's an okay thing to express yourself. Have you seen...
No,
I hate to bring this up, but Kate Hudson, she's 22, she's in Sheets. Jennifer Lopez, she poses very provocatively sometimes. Christina Aguilera, what's the big deal when I do it? Like, come on! You know? I don't understand.
I think everybody always thought you had a different relationship to young girls.
Everyone now, they look back and they're like, what happened to your sweet image that you used to be? And I'm like, then when I came out, you thought I was too provocative. It's like you can never win. No matter what you do, at the end of the day, you can't please everybody. You know, I'm not here to please.
Britney Spears has upset a lot of mothers in this country, starting with the wife of the governor of Maryland, who appeared at an anti-violence rally, and, well, listen to what she said.
Really, if I had an opportunity to shoot Britney Spears, I think I would.
Oh, that's horrible.
Well, she...
That's really bad.
Because of the example for kids and how hard it is to be a parent and keep all of this away from your kids.
Well, that's really sad that she said that. Ew. You know what? Like, I'm not here to, you know, babysit her kids.
Later, the governor's wife had to retract her statement because of a public outcry about her reference to guns. But it is true that kids made Britney Spears. And then she remade them in her image. And then, in the past 2 years, that image has taken a highly explicit turn as she searched for a new edge. We wondered, does she care what her old fans, those kids, think?
I mean, I can't help that. And if the parents don't like them to see it, then change the channel. So, sorry, you know. I'm not perfect. I make mistakes every day, honey. I know, but I want to be a good person for me, but I think it's a huge pressure to think that you have to take the responsibility to be this role model.
It's one thing not to want to be the role model anymore. It's another thing not to know that a lot of young girls are looking at this. A lot of them.
But am I responsible for them?
Have you ever gone further than you wish you had?
Gone further?
Yeah.
No. I don't think so. No. Okay. Now, those are a little much. Yeah, those are a little, much. At the end of the shoot, I was like, all right, let's go ahead and do it, and then let's jet. And I didn't have approval over the thing. So that's one picture, I must say, that I felt kind of weird about. Yeah. You know what? I really like that outfit. Oh, and I got to go out with Michael Jackson. Huh, that was cool. So happy birthday, my friend, the King of Pop.
He's still an idol of yours?
Yeah, I think that he's done, if you really think of a genius that he is, I mean, he's brilliant. And Billie Jean, all the old stuff that he used to do, I think he's great.
Doesn't he worry you, though? The baby over the balcony kind of Michael Jackson?
Well, I think maybe growing up, like, such a young age, and it's probably affected him somewhat, and maybe it's kind of, but I think he's a great person at heart, and I just think maybe he needs me to call him, maybe. You know, he probably needs some friends around him, to be honest, or, you know.
You think all the stuff written about him is untrue with little kids?
I want to think that's untrue. I choose to believe that's untrue. Yeah.
Michael Jackson?
Oh, God.
Michael Jackson?
I thought you were going to go here first. I was hoping you forgot.
Why did you marry Michael Jackson?
Okay, can I just... Well...
What were you doing?
No. I've been trying to go through this. I haven't thought much about this, what I was going to say, but I just figured it'd fly out of my mouth. Okay, first of all, I heard he wanted to meet me when I was 18. I didn't want to because I thought he was a freak. And I just want to say he's not stupid. He didn't get where he was because he's stupid. And not... It's unfortunate that not a lot of people know who he really is. He doesn't let anybody see it. And he has some idea about how he should represent himself in the public that he thinks works for him, which is this sort of meek, victim-y, quiet thing that he does, which is not anything like how he really is. So he doesn't let a lot of people see that. I fell into this whole, you poor, sweet, misunderstood thing, I'm going to save you, you know. I fell in love with him. I did. I'm in love. Yes, I fell in love at the time. Now,
sexual attraction?
I told you. Everything I said was the truth.
Sexual attraction.
At the time. Yeah.
What about the way he looks?
I told you, see, now, I'm not attracted to mediocrity or normalcy or things like that. I think certain things are, I'm weird. I don't know. I'm whacked.
Nobody thought this would last.
Okay.
What did your mother say?
She called me and said there are, you know, oh, Lisa, there's helicopters outside the house and they're saying you married Michael Jackson. And I was just quiet. And she goes, you didn't. She goes, you didn't. And I go, yeah, I did. And then it was just like, you know, that was game on for me. Woo, mom doesn't like it. Let's go. I don't know.
But she didn't know you were going to get married.
No.
And you did live together?
Yeah.
I didn't believe that.
Well, let's just put it this way. If he was in town, he was at my house.
Which was how often?
Well, I don't know. It started to get less and less towards the end.
Again, you can slug me on this question, but I gotta go back. So these were like romantic nights?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I don't remember them very well, but yes. I mean, it was normal. I wasn't gonna get married if it wasn't that. But see, then it was like wanting to get married. So I don't know if it was, you know, like I even remember thinking, how is that gonna happen? You know, I can't even imagine him like that, whatever. And then he quickly disillusioned me of that idea. But, you know, I don't want to go off. I don't want to keep talking about him. I don't want to knock him. You know what I mean? I'm really not interested in, like, going off on him.
What about him and drugs?
I never saw it, but I suspected. I don't know, though.
Are you sorry now that you went out and put your credibility there for him? Gave him that?
Am I sorry now? It's something that I don't think I'll ever shake, but, you know, I mean, it's more just frustrating because I know people, you know me or see who I am and be like, hi, you seem like you're all right. What was that? You know what I mean? Basically.
I'm so glad you put something around you because I was feeling guilty. I had a coat on and you didn't, but not guilty enough to take it off.
It's very cold.
So, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
You know, when we scheduled this concert, I'm thinking back, months and months and months and months ago, nobody had any idea that 2 months ago there would be this explosion that would take over a large part of your life. I gotta ask you, if you could go back 2 months to those seconds, how much would you pay to do it differently, and what would you do?
I definitely would love to do it over again, and for sure, I know it wouldn't happen the way that it did.
How soon? No, you finish.
Well, you know, things happen. It's out of your control, and you just have to roll with the punches and you move on. You know?
How soon afterwards did you know that this was something seismic?
Gosh, I had gotten back to the hotel, and we were getting ready to go out that evening. And I ran to a friend's room, and she happened to be watching CNN. And there I saw the performance, or that actual clip, and there was a headline underneath talking about Justin and I being arrested in Houston, possibly. So I just was really taken aback. I didn't know that it really had escalated into such a massive...
We're having a little trouble hearing that. Okay, I saw David Letterman on Monday night.
Oh, you did?
I did. And he really grilled your heart. And I heard what you were saying, that you're not yet ready to go back and do detail by detail of what you intended. And then what you said was, I think you said, not supposed to happen like that. Something came out too far. I think that's what you said. But well, I got to ask you this. Yeah?
Kind of like that, but not like that. What? It was kind of like that, but not like that.
Okay. I got to ask you this, though, because there are a lot of people who said, I'm just convinced that this was rock shock and that it just backfired, that it was something that was intended and just backfired. I don't believe it was accidental.
I've never done any stunts or anything like that, and it was an accident. It truly was an accident. And I mean, like I said, there was nothing that you could do about it, and you just got to roll with the punches. And I've moved on. I've moved on from it.
What did your mom say to you?
Oh, she was very supportive. She said, "I know you're a very strong woman," and she said, "Just keep the faith and it'll pass." And she said, "I don't know why they're trying to do this to you, but it'll soon pass. And just stay strong, baby." And I have. And I have her strength, and I thank God for that.
But I think people have tried to imagine what it was to be you, seeing this go by, played over and over again, over and over and over again. I don't know how many times you saw it. And wondering if it shook you, if it changed you in some way.
It made me stronger. That's what it did. It made me much stronger.
I don't think anybody expected you to come out in turtlenecks singing.
I think they're basically saying they want to talk about the album.
At any point did you say, I'm going to change what I wear, I'm going to change what I sing about?
No, I have to be who I am. There were people that wanted me to take certain songs off the album because they thought it would pose a problem, but that would be changing who I am, and I'll never do that for anyone, for anyone.
That's a general issue, because this is a no kidding. Okay, I got an insurrection out here.
I think they want to talk about the album.
But this is a serious issue, which is, you know, a lot of people said, how are we going to control on television what our kids see? And you know all the, you know, all of the talk, the delays that are taking place and all that. If you were answering them, what would you say?
Well, you know, I think that was already in the making. I think I was just kind of the poster child for them. I was the pawn that they used to put me behind it to kind of push it forward, so to speak. In the rest of the world, I just got back from Europe, and they don't understand what all the hoopla is about, really, and they don't understand why America is reacting in such a way. But you know, what can you
all
say?
Right. Okay, I can't read lips up here anymore, guys.
Are you trying to read my lips?
I'm trying to read your lips because I can barely hear you.
I want to put it behind me, and I really don't want to talk about it ever again.
It occurs to me, looking at the two of you, I have got to start by asking how this marriage took place, how it began. Let me guess that it was not over miniature golf and a hot dog someplace. Mm-hmm. When did it start? When was the dating? Mm-hmm. Who proposed? I mean, how did marriage actually get discussed?
Well, at first, this is what happened. When she was 18, I used to tell my lawyer, John Branca, do you know Lisa Marie Presley? He'd go, well, I represent her mother. I go, well, can you get in touch with her? Because I think she's really cute. And he'd laugh every time. He goes, I'll do my best, that's what he'd say. Then he'd come back, I said, well, did you find out? He said, no, there's nothing. So I would worry him about this all the time. And the next thing I noticed, there's a picture on a magazine cover where she's married, which really tore me to pieces.
And
it really did, because I felt that was supposed to be me, I really did.
And what was the countdown to your marriage? Tell me who said the word marriage first.
I did.
He did.
I did.
When, where?
When,
on
where?
On the telephone.
On the telephone.
He first asked me.
When?
We were dating now for 4 months. 4 months?
I don't remember.
Well, anyway, we were spending a lot of time together. I don't know how it managed to get in the press because we weren't hiding it. I was in Las Vegas. We were in Neverland.
We were everywhere.
I went to Atlanta. We were in bookstores. We were not hiding it.
And you said yes right away?
I was separated for 4 months, and he said, what would you do if I asked you to marry me? And I said, I would.
As you know, the reaction to this marriage, and I know you feel strongly about it, but the reaction to this marriage has been across the spectrum, everything from astonishment to delight to suspicion, that it was somehow too convenient. Lisa, did you ask Michael about the charges? Did the two of you talk about the impact of the marriage on the allegations?
Absolutely not. He called, I was in touch with him through the whole process of this charges going on. I was talking to him when he disappeared. I was actually supposed to go to San Juan, Puerto Rico when he left and disappeared, and I got a call that he wasn't going to be there, and I was actually part of the whole thing with him, but talking to him on the phone. So
did you say to him, are they true?
No, I didn't.
I think I want to begin by making sure that the terms are clear. You have said that you would never harm a child. I want to be specific as I can. Did you ever, as this young boy said you did you ever sexually engage, fondle, have sexual contact with this child or any other child?
Never, ever. I could never harm a child or anyone. It's not in my heart. It's not who I am. And it's not what I'm I'm not even interested in that.
And what do you think should be done to someone who does that?
To someone who does that, what I think it should be done? Gee, I think they need help in some kind of way, you know?
How about the police photographs, though? How was there enough information from this boy about those kinds of things?
The police photographs,
photographs
that they took of me.
Yes.
There was nothing that matched me to those charges.
There was nothing. There was nothing that concurred.
That's
nothing?
Why I'm sitting here talking to you today. There was not one iota of information that was found that could connect me to these charges.
So when we've heard that there was a marking of some kind.
No markings.
No markings.
No.
The
whole thing is a lie.
Why did you settle the case then? Why did you settle the case? And it looks to everyone as if you paid a huge amount of money.
Well, that's most of that's
to get
folklore.
Silence.
I talked to my lawyers and I said, can you guarantee me that justice will prevail? And they said, Michael, we cannot guarantee you that a judge or a jury will do anything. And with that, I was like catatonic. I was outraged.
How much money
totally
was it?
Totally outraged. So what I said, I have got to do something to get out from under this nightmare. All these lies and all these people coming forward to get paid and these tabloid shows, just lies, 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 lies. So what I did, we got together again with my advisors and they advised me, it was hands down a unanimous decision, resolve the case. This could be something that could go on for 7 years.
How much
money
was
it? We said, let's get it behind us.
Can you say how much?
It's not what the tabloids have printed. It's not all this crazy outlandish money. No, it's not at all. I mean, the terms of the agreement are very confidential.
He's been barred to discuss it.
The specific terms, the specific amounts.
The idea is just isn't fair. What they put me through, because there wasn't one piece of information that says I did that. And anyway, they turned my room upside down, went through all my books, all my videotapes, all my private things, and they found nothing, nothing, nothing that can say Michael Jackson did this. Nothing.
But let me ask you a couple
of questions.
To this day,
nothing. Still, nothing.
Let me ask you a couple.
Nothing, nothing, nothing.
Nothing. I got nothing. As you may or may not know, we have called everyone we can call. We have checked everything we can check. We have gone and tried to see if what we heard before is in fact the case. I want to ask you about two things. These reports that we read over and over again, that in your rooms they found photographs of young boys, not of adults.
Young boys, not children, all kind of girls and everything.
And that they found photographs, books, of young boys who were undressed.
No.
Didn't happen.
No, not that I know of, unless people sent me things that I haven't opened. People know my love for children, so they send me books from all over the world, from South America, from Germany, from Italy, from Sweden.
So if people say that they found those things, if there's an indication, let them come forward, let them produce them, right?
Yeah, because you wouldn't believe the amounts of mail that I get. And if you say to somebody, you know, if I let the fans know I love Charlie Chaplin, I'll be swarmed in Charlie Chaplin paraphernalia.
But if
I say I love children, which I do, they swarm me with everything pertaining to kids.
Any other settlements in process now or previously with children making these kinds of claims? We have heard that there is one. Not a case that the prosecutors would bring in court, but that once again, you're talking about shelling out.
No, that's not true. No. No, it's not true. I think I've heard everything is fine and there are no others.
I guess, let me ask this, and I'm trying to think how to phrase it, though. I can hear out in the country people saying, and you've been cleared of all the charges, we want to make that clear. People saying, look, here is a man who is surrounded by things that children love. Here is a man who spent an inordinate amount of time with these young boys.
That's right.
What is a 36-year-old man doing sleeping with a 12-year-old boy or a series of them?
Right. Okay, when you say boys, it's not just boys, and I've never invited just boys to come in my room. Come on, that's ridiculous. And that's a ridiculous question. But since people want to hear it, you know, the answer, I'll be happy to answer it. I have never invited anyone into my bed, ever. Children love me, I love them, they follow me, they want to be with me. But anybody can come in my bed. A child can come in my bed if they want.
I can say, I've seen this. I've seen it a lot. I've seen kids. I've seen him with children in the last year. I've seen it enough to where I can see how that can happen. It's, you know, I
but
understand.
Isn't part of being an adult, and you have a two-year-old child, two-year-old boy.
Yeah, let me just, sorry.
Okay.
I just wanted to say that I've seen these children. They don't let him go to the bathroom without running in there with them. And they won't let him out of their sight. So when he jumps in the bed, I'm even out. You know, they jump in the bed with him.
But isn't part of being an adult and loving children, keeping children from ambiguous situations? And again, we're talking about over an intense period of time here. Would you let your son, when he grows up and is 12 years old, do that?
You know what, if I didn't know who Michael, no way. But I happen to know who he is and what he is. And that makes it, you know, I know that he's not, you know, I know that he's not like that, and I know he has a thing for children, and I, go ahead. Sorry.
I just wonder, is it over? You're going to make sure it doesn't happen again. I think this is really the key thing people want to know, that they're not going to be more of these sleepovers in which people have to wonder.
Nobody wonders when kids sleep over at my house.
But
nobody
are they
wonders.
Over? Are you going to watch out for it now?
Watch out for
just
what?
Just for the sake of the children and for
no,
everything you've
all,
been through.
No, because it's all moral and it's all pure. I don't even think that way. It's not what's in my heart.
So you'll do
never,
it again?
I would never, ever. Do what again?
I mean, you'll have a child
sleeping
over.
Of course. They want.
Yes.
It's on the level of purity and love and just innocence, complete innocence. If you're talking about sex, then that's a nut. That's not me. Go to the guy down the street because it's not Michael Jackson. It's not what I'm interested in.
So, I know that you, Lisa Marie, have wanted to talk about this. There are a lot of doubters about this marriage. What is it you love the most about him?
What do I love the most about him? Everything. He's amazing. I really admire him. I respect him. I admire him. I'm in love with him. And no, we don't sleep in separate bedrooms. Thank you very much. And,
you said you don't sleep in separate bedrooms, and I'm going to confess, okay, this is live TV, and I'm copping out right here because I didn't spend my life as a serious journalist to ask these kinds of questions. But I'm not oblivious to the fact that your fans had one question they most wanted to ask of you.
Do we have sex?
We have, you.
Stop. You she didn't that. Ask. She
I didn't
ask.
I won't ask. Is that what you were gonna ask?
Let's play just a minute or
sorry.
Two. Let's play one or two.
We wanna know if you've done the thing. Michael, I know that this is an intimate question, but are you having sex together with Lisa Marie? Do you guys really love each other, or are you just doing this to satisfy the media? Are you guys intimate? Again, I can't believe it. This is about pure skepticism.
Yes, yes, yes.
We're going to show you a film now created by Michael Jackson, and it is causing a furor in some movie theaters around this country. They say, among other things, that it is clearly modeled after Triumph of the Will, Leni Riefenstahl, a Nazi film
it's
with Nazi
imagery.
It's not
true. None of that's true. None of those things are true.
Did you watch that film before you did it?
I watch everything. I love movies. So I love documentaries. It had nothing to do with that at all.
But there are people who keep saying, this is... They look at it and say, this is...
Absolutely not.
You know what?
Nothing to do with politics or communism or fascism.
Well,
at all.
The critics have said that it's the most boldly vainglorious self-deification a pop singer ever undertook with a straight face.
Good. That's what I wanted.
For the controversy?
Yeah.
And
they
for the
fell into my trap.
For the people who say that...
I wanted everybody's attention.
But for the people who say those symbols matter, they're about suffering.
The symbol has nothing to do with that. It's not political. It's not fascist. It's not dogma. It's not, you know, ideology and all of this stuff. It's pure, simple love. You don't see any tanks. You don't see any cannons. It's about love. It's people coming together.
About love. We're going to let everybody watch a bit.
Yeah, but it's art. It's art.
Okay.
The way a director would use a medium to create art.
Here it comes. There's been another issue raised in a song. You say, Jew me, sue me. And some people are saying that that is anti-Semitic.
It's not anti-Semitic because I'm not a racist person. I could never be a racist. I love all races of people, from Arabs to Jewish people, like I said before, to blacks. But when I say Jew me, sue me, everybody do me, kick me, kike me, don't you black or white me, I'm talking about myself as the victim. You know, my accountants and lawyers are Jewish. My three best friends are Jewish. David Geffen, Jeffrey Katzenberg, Steven Spielberg, Mike Milken. These are friends of mine. They're all Jewish. So how does that make sense? I was raised in a Jewish community.
I want to ask you both about something, because it was the second most asked question by people on the street. And I know it's a sensitive issue for you, and you talked with Oprah about it. But somehow people still are not, they don't feel they've heard everything about the whiteness of your skin, and that it's not somehow a choice on your part, along with the makeup, to be, is it to be neither black or white, neither to look completely male, to be in the androgynous zone? I think they want to know, it is a decision on your part some way, the way you look. Where does it come from?
I think it creates itself. Nature.
He's an artist. Every right, and he is constantly remodifying something or changing it or reconstructing it or, you know, working on some imperfection that he thinks needs to be worked on. If he sees something he doesn't like, he changes it. Period. He re-sculpted himself. He's an artist.
I might want to put a red dot right there one day.
But
two eyes right here.
Do you wish you were the color you were again?
Do I wish I was the
that color?
That's nature. That I love black. I love
Do you wish you were that way?
I envy her because she can tan and I can't.
One more question I want to make sure I ask. Are you going to sing together?
No.
I would love to sing with you.
Mm-mm.
Would you like to sing with me?
You don't sing?
I don't sing. I did sing, but that's not why I married Michael. I don't need that. That's ridiculous. If I wanted it, I mean, I'm not going to marry someone for a recording career, just to clear that up as well.
What?
Stop.
And tonight is over. Look at that.
He's a nut.
Will love. We'll probably have some final thoughts on all this ourselves next week. Until then, I'm Diane Sawyer.
The album was Rhythm Nation. The subject was race in America. Janet Jackson says it's a prejudiced country still.
I don't know if you feel it, but I do. And it hurts.
Tiny, toxic darts that a racist world fires off.
Tiny. Yeah.
And do you think I'm completely incapable of understanding what it is?
Yes, because you are on the other side.
Girl, the shade of it all.